Okay, this is a rig right here. My only other option to keep those batteries charged up would be to pull them out of the boat, unwire them, take them out of the boat, take them back to house, charge them up on a regular electrical charger, bring them back out, put them in the boat, wire them back up. Well, that's a lot of work. So because we get so much sunlight here, and I should have mentioned that earlier, this is actually the sunniest place in the United States. It's also the hottest. So with that said, this could be, you know, somewhat detrimental. I don't know yet because I haven't tried this during extreme heat, but they say that when it gets really hot, it decreases the efficiency of these solar panels, but that remains to be seen. But anyway, we'll walk over here and see what we got. Okay, start with this one right here. That's a Harbor Freight 13.5 watt solar panel, 24 or 12 volts. I've got it hooked up to a battery. It's underneath that hatch right there. 12 volt, 101 amp hour marine battery, and what that does is powers that depth finder or fish finder. I think it's a Lowrance Elite something or other. Another one, a newer model Lowrance. That supplies power to both those fish finders because they will draw power. And I want to keep it isolated from the cranking battery. I want my cranking battery basically to crank the motor, and that's all. Now, the aerators on the live wells are hooked to it. Two of those, a trim, of course, for the motor, the lights, you know, odds and ends, sump pump. But basically, I very seldom ever use any of that stuff. I actually use my live wells for an ice chest most of the time. I ice down some soda pops, a gallon of water, some sandwiches. I really don't use live wells that much. Okay. So that thing works pretty well. It'll maintain a trickle charge. And it'll actually do some actual charging on it. It will charge it up if you don't let it go down too low. Now, like I said, the heat is supposed to decrease efficiency. That I don't really know yet because we haven't got into the extreme heat, but it's getting here. I've been using this since late winter, early spring, and it worked great. I mean, kicking out the voltage. So we'll just have to see how that goes, but undoubtedly I think it's gonna do the job anyway. I think it's gonna get enough sunlight, and then of course we got early morning, late in the evening when it cools down, still have sun, so. Now, time will tell on that, and I'll give an update at some point. I'm not going to get into details about wiring this stuff up. It's really simple. Now, I will say on this one, if you do something like this, don't bother to put a regulator on it because it'll just steal power away from that thing. It's only 13.5 watts. We're just going straight power without a regulator. It does pretty well. Now, I'll go back here. Again, I'm not going to bore anybody with the details, but this is one panel of a 100-watt Harbor Freight solar array. I've got four of those panels. What I'll do is lay them all across this deck, hook them up. Like I say, it's all self-explanatory. There's dozens of YouTube videos showing exactly how to hook up those 100-watt solar panels from Harbor Freight, so no sense in me repeating, going through stuff that have been gone over 100 times. Here's the voltage regulator that I will use with the four solar panels, because that's putting out 100 watts. Over here, that's gonna power a charge by two trolling motor batteries under there. I do have to do a little rewiring when I go that option and take them, unwire them from 24 volts to 12 volts. Which is really simple. I use, you know, set of jumper cables and stuff, unhook stuff. Because that thing charges at 12 volts and I got 24 volts. So basically what I'm doing is putting, charging up two batteries parallel to each other on 12 volts. Works great. That 100 watts does the job, and it so far it's charging batteries up. Nothing flat. Walk over here. I'm not charging right now because I don't have to. See, get around here, see if maybe you can see this. Okay, of course you see this has got a get out of the way, dude. Okay, that's got a little meter right there we're showing. Well, don't mighty. Turn on my trolling motor. Okay, it's showing 24.9 volts, so that don't need charging right now. I just took it off the charger not long ago. So anyway, that's an option. And I think it'll work anywhere. You don't have to be out here in the Phoenix, Arizona area. It might even work better if you're in a cooler area. I mean, it works off sunlight. Except heat don't really help things. It makes things worse. If anything, and that's one thing that we get a lot of here is heat. I mean, we'll get days, you know, 110, 115 is pretty common in the summer, and sometimes it'll creep on up around 120. Is what it is. I'll know more about it as the summer wears on. Probably give an update, but anyway, if that's something you might be interested in, if you're in a position where you don't have electricity and you got a boat, there's lots of them around. There's boats all over this thing, bass boats, everything. God almighty, you name it, cabin cruisers out here. Most people don't bother to do this because they don't ever take them out. Don't really know why they got them, but anyway, they do. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and it's, you know, maybe give you an idea what to try. I think it'll work in any part of the country you're in. Over and out.